Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3 for your patience, guys. It's been a minute as I'm getting things set up here, and we're just talking about Hokuto and wasting time. Yo, what's up? Welcome back to Vencabot. Code Vein action. My name is David. We're talking about anime in the chat. Of course, we have to talk about anime. We're playing Code Vein. And I'm talking about our personal taste in anime. Me and Yoga Brain talking about Hokuto no Ken, Fist of the North Star. Go watch it, guys. It was pretty much the grandfather of all modern shonen anime. And it's so, so good. It's held up so well over the years. And there's something special about the animation from that era that is just so magical to watch play out. Like, the animation quality is so high. It's so good. It's a very, very long series. It actually comes in two parts. Hokuto Part 1 is hundreds of episodes. Hokuto Part 2 is hundreds of more episodes. But it's so, so good. It's worth it.
Shall we?
It's just fucking sick, huh? Faust says, I know someone who watches all seasonal anime at like 15 to 2 times speed. I've mentioned that before, Faust. He's a friend that just watches it at double speed. That's crazy to me. It's just so sick. Hokuto no Ken. It can't be described. Honestly, Goblin Slayer game in this style, huh? This game is looking real, real good. Like, the actual character models are good, but the environments are kind of low poly and also a little bit on the ugly side so far anyway. I'm kind of disappointed by that, but it's also, it clearly doesn't have the budget of Dark Souls, but it's doing a pretty admirable job with what it has. If you guys missed the last episode, the lore right now is that my character lost his memory, surprise, surprise. It literally starts with a soft female voice going, "Wake up, wake up." I'm like, are you serious? Is that an homage at this point, or is it just a fucking cliche? But anyway, so you wake up, you're an amnesiac, of course, you're a JRPG protagonist. And we're in this post-apocalypse where very few human beings are left, and a lot of us are revenants, they're called. We're like vampires. We are stronger than human beings, and we must feed on blood to survive. Because there are so few humans left, we have to harvest blood from these blood plants, basically. They're called missile, I think, and they can yield what are called blood beads. They're like a fruit. And I guess my character was enslaved recently by some banditos who owe blood beads to the government, basically. So there's kind of like post-apocalyptic loose government, and they're hitting up all these bandit groups for blood beads, and they ran out of resources, so they're starting to kidnap people, and we're one of them. Hey, listen. Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous. The combat's very Dark Souls-esque, but it's definitely not a bad thing at all. It's got its own stuff going on, though. It's pretty much, like Faust was saying yesterday, it kind of sucks that in a post-Dark Souls world, we have to compare all games to Dark Souls, but it is an action RPG with some very Dark Souls-esque elements and plot themes. Like, also, I should point out that these revenants, if they don't get blood for a while or go out into this mist, there's like an evil mist outside of some of the cities, they can turn into what are called the Lost, which are basically just hollows. So as a revenant, I am a undead in Dark Souls, and I can become a hollow if I become lost. It's almost so much like Dark Souls. I mentioned in the last stream that when this game was first announced, being published by Namco Bandai, I thought maybe it would be a spinoff. Like a really, honestly, an anime spinoff of Dark Souls that was going to be like a reinterpretation. And maybe it was at one point, and they changed the name at some point to kind of differentiate it, but it is very much, very close to Dark Souls in some surprising ways. But the actual mechanics are not all from Dark Souls. There's some pretty cool stuff going on with skill learning and equipping and gear management, and it's pretty cool. I like this little magic bar I have. That 30 out of 30 in the lower right is my magic amount, and that's pretty fun to work with. It's actually pretty nice. Demon's Souls kind of snowballed and fashioned a new genre, huh? Or a twist on an old one, probably. Yeah. It's just an action RPG, but there are still elements that you just cannot deny are inspired by Dark Souls. Like, Dark Souls and Demon's Souls were not the very first action RPG ever, but
getting attacked here would be
serious. The way these games play is nevertheless very Souls-esque. Is the connectivity between areas Souls-esque? I don't know. We started yesterday. I'm in the first area, so I'm still in the tutorial. I really hope that there's a world to explore. So far, I've been really impressed by the level design in this first area. Like, even compared to Dark Souls, there is a lot of cool branching paths. Oh, hi. It's been really fun to kind of find treasure and explore and look around, and that's something that really draws me to games is, the exploring aspect.
It's quite valuable. Let's use it well.
But yeah, you can tell that the graphics are just not on the same level as Dark Souls, but that's fine. Neither goes the budget. I prefer checkpoints to hubs myself, huh? I think that my favorite game in the Souls series is Demon's Souls because of how good the exploring worked in that game. It had a hub like Demon's Souls, excuse me, unlike Dark Souls. But I think the hub in that case, I don't mind hubs as long as they separate worlds that are individually fun to explore. In Demon's Souls, they were, and in not every game is that the case. Oftentimes, having a hub will mean that the small levels are just that, they're small levels. Where I felt like in Demon's Souls, it made sense to split it up, because the worlds were large and fun to explore, and they were varied in a way that you couldn't have if they were all connected. So I'm not necessarily against any game that has a hub.
Don't lose your footing.
I wouldn't cry if this game had one. But it does ruin a lot of games for me, like the exploration aspect that has a hub. You ever play Phantasy Star Online on GameCube or Dreamcast? I played it very briefly on Dreamcast, but not extensively. Bonfire shenanigans and such appealed to me more. I don't like bonfire teleporting either. I liked it more in Dark Souls 1, where not every bonfire could teleport you. So it made it more like exploring was still a thing. As always, love hanging out, but sleep can be calling. Good night, cheese. Have fun and good night, Venka and chat. Have a good rest, my friend. Thanks for coming by and hanging out during Kirby. I've always felt that games set the precedent for games like Demon's Souls, more so than a lot of people realize, huh? Maybe you're right, Yoga Brain. Now that I think about it, it has some similar elements. With the way that you kind of target enemies and stuff. But, you know, they didn't have that fluency, like the fluidness to movement and such during combat. I think it's kind of Dark Souls-y. Get the fucker over there. Now, what can I do? I can shoot magic at this guy and stuff. There's a fucker hiding out right there, too. There's a cliff there between me and him. There's a guy laying down there. He might get up. Probably not, though. These are the Lost, by the way. They're just like me, but they're, you know, hollows. They're exactly. They really borrow that from Dark Souls pretty hard. I'm a revenant, that means I'm like a vampire. These are hollows. My partner's pretty ripped. So I mastered all my skills. So this game has a mechanic sort of like Final Fantasy Tactics, where you can learn skills as one class, and then if you master them, you can take them to another class. So I've been kind of going between the classes to get my skills maxed out, and now I have, so I can really be any class I want to now. They're all pretty fun, they're all kind of unique so far. I only have three to unlock more as the game goes on, I guess.
I'll keep watch then.
Yeah, I think I probably like fighter the most, just the most straightforward. No fluidity, no dodge. Very archaic in that sense. But yeah, like I said, the targeting is kind of like Dark Souls, and the pace as well, the slow pace. Same as Dark Souls, Eddie. You lose your souls and you have to go back and get them. If you look in the lower left, you can see, actually, I'm kind of covering up. Oh, I need to fix my, I only have 4x3 on right now. That's so stupid, guys. Let me fix that. Let's see here. Ta-da. Okay. So now I can do this. I can go, where am I at here? Right here. Peekaboo. So if you look in the lower left, you can see my souls. I have 600 right now. Above that's my HP. That big, and above my HP bar is my stamina bar. Kind of like Dark Souls. Then you have my partner's stuff up there. On the right are my magic spells. Let me actually even do this. Let's see here. Right here. So on the right, you can see my skills that are equipped, like my magic spells, basically. And the other squares below that are for more spells. I don't have those equipped yet at all. It's kind of like the HUD there, which you're looking at. Not a whole lot going on. I'm gonna put the chat room back up and my face cam back up. We're not missing a whole lot, I don't think.
What's wrong? You need to go back?
Alright. I don't gotta go back, dude. Jeez. Got my case. I still got all my Estus and stuff. Good to go, dude. What are you worried about? So I've got souls. You die, you lose me. I go pick them up. I feel like this environment is very samey. If I had to guess, I would say it's going to be how they're going to save money throughout the course of the game. If this environment is anything to go on, it would seem that the areas are large. Where the fuck is this guy coming from? Take this. The environments are very large, and they have a lot of cool pathways to explore, but The graphics are very samey and repetitive. There's stuff going on down there. I'd probably fall in there and fight those guys, huh? Probably end up down there eventually. Do you stock magic or use MP? I have MP. So that little number in the lower right, the 22 out of 30, is my MP. And it's a really fun mechanic, in my opinion, compared to other Dark Souls games, because it's used for not only magic spells, but also gunshots, and warrior skills use it. And you get it back by incorporating these claw moves into your combos. Like if I were to say, do this, then do this. Right, that claw gives me MP back. Furthermore, if I get backstabs, it gives me MP back. And if I get an attack like this, I get MP back. So it's kind of a fun way to sort of balance this meter where I can use my skills. Enjoying it so far? It's on sale again, so torn, considering maybe this or God Eater 3. It's the same director, you know that power, Penguin Powered? Same director. This is the guy that did the God Eater series, created this game. Which I say he, was the guy that directed it. Welcome back, Gun Machine. Fusion! It's like Quicksilver Bolt and Blood, yeah, kind of, but again, they're useful for more than just bullets. So I think it's a really fun little mechanic there. Also, if I get, if I do this attack on foes, I get a temporary boost to my max MP that lasts until I rest at the bonfire. So you can actually boost your max MP by using these claw moves. It's kind of fun. You had me at anime, huh? God Eater 3 is like anime Monster Hunter, and this is like anime Dark Souls. It's interesting that it's the same director.
You wouldn't come back.
I've seen God Eater gameplay, and it never really appealed to me. So the fact that the same guy kind of created this is kind of interesting. I find this a lot less interesting. Oh, this guy fucking had a homie there, having his back. This partner thing is kind of distracting, which is kind of why I don't really care for partners in Dark Souls either. So partners are a big part of this game, like balance-wise, in terms of the gameplay, in terms of the management. You have this partner as like a constant guy on your team, if you want. And they're pretty strong. I don't mind the jabber-drawing that much. But I kind of find it frustrating that I can't, like, predict how much health my opponent's going to have. Because I don't know who he's going to fight. And then, their health kind of... I feel like I'm running away sometimes, letting him fight. Nothing personal, kid. Backstabber! The guy's like, bah! Bacana! There are items that use bullets that were parries / bullets in Bloodborne. Oh yeah, I forgot. So the spells used that always use the Quicksilver Bolts? I forgot about that. I didn't really fuck with those. I remember those things now. They're like little items you could equip. They're like spells, basically. Sometimes enemies appear. I'm not sure if they actually just literally appeared. Or if they got it from somewhere. Cole's still greater than Sonic, huh? Partner, I think you mean Mule. The items did, like the old hunter bone exactly, he's 5. Okay, I didn't know that. Yeah, exactly. It's kind of what these are. They're like Quicksilver bullets. Like Eddie said. Now wait. I can go back. What is this? Looks like a missile. So the missile acts as... Oh, look, there's the surface. So I don't want to go to the surface. I want to go down here and explore somewhere. So is there a secret area down here? I feel like... I swear I could fall and not die. Yeah, look, there's all kinds of stuff. I could just fall down there. Maybe. Maybe it's already there at one point. Maybe I'm going back. There's open chests down there. I probably did come from that way, huh? At some point. Oh shit.
I don't want to run into any enemies.
Yeah, hunter tools, here. Exactly what they're called. Hunter tools. I never fuck with those. If I go here, I take a shortcut down there. But why should I? I've already got that treasure, looks like. I probably was already down there once. I can see to my map as well. Probably just a shortcut if I want to go back. Let's not do that then. I don't think it's a second in at all. So I was telling Yoga Brain earlier, I kind of enjoy exploring this game, which is awesome. But The fact that everything looks kind of samey makes it kind of hard to know where you are, at least in this first dungeon. I think that was a cost-saving measure. It can be kind of frustrating to navigate sometimes in that respect. So these rotten ones, they cannot be used to save your game or to level up. They just work as a way to make the map explored for you.
Back on the surface again.
I guess. So we got, what, did we get a blood bead? I think we did get one blood bead, didn't we, or didn't we? There's a healing bell that was handy. Didn't care to tweak my stats for damage with those tools. And bloodborne.
Good. That's light from the surface.
Yeah, but we have to get the fucking... Oh, this might be a boss here. It's a boss arena. We need so what kind of abilities do I have? Restorative Offering, Bloodshot, Blazing Roar, Sonic Arrow. This is the worst class to be for a boss fight. I don't want to be a wizard. Let's change. You can change anywhere you want, I guess. I got the Bloodbeat thing. Okay, canonically, I got it. I like the Ruined City environment, actually. Yeah, post-apocalypse, I guess. I think I'm going to be fighter, getting high defense. Let's see here. Okay, that's nice. I lose Drain, but I don't really care about that. I lose some of my gift stuff, I don't care about that either. Okay, I want to have this big fucking sword, I guess. Okay. A lost broadsword, not quite as good as this. Okay, anything else that's stronger than this? Okay. Good night, Connor, have a good rest. When you embiggen the tree, I remember that part. I just wasn't sure I got anything for it. Health boost, focus stamina usage. I want a stamina boost as well. And, darkest while I'm focused. Okay, while I'm focused. I might do, weapon drain rating up. Okay. It's just like you make your build in this game, right? You kind of unlock abilities from each class and you can kind of equip them later if you master them. It's kind of cool. Triple Annihilator, Adrenaline. I can use a Sonic Arrow to hit from a range if I want to. I also make my attack venomous. Okay. Shifting Hollow, I can dash forward and be invincible, I guess. Spoil Spotter, sort of offering, and Blood Guard. Blood resistance, huh? I mean, and my partner. Might be useful for a boss fight. Kind of feel like this might be useful too, just hit from far away with a, if I, you know, while I'm waiting for my turn. Might be good. Let's keep it simple and go with this. In case he has like any kind of projectile attacks. I think what says blood resistance means like projectiles. Just another RPG is bringing what will it be to thee, huh?
What will it be to thee? What will it be to thee?
Yeah, good night, Connor. Have you pick anything you like. Yeah, Eddie remembers. Yeah, I guess about this. I guess I'll put on the Sonic Arrow on this if I wanted to. Maybe I do. I put on a lot of skills, really. Even put Venom on there. Okay, whatever, man. I have this giant sword now. I have some new clothes. Feeling quite angsty. My items are all here. What do I have in terms of items, anyway? Inventory. Oh, what we got here? Daggers. Chemical lights. Don't care about that. Bloodstained stakes. Don't care. Needle of Unity. Don't care about that. Venom cartridge. Adds venom to my weapon. Don't care about that. Lost shards. Okay, I gotcha. There's a frog reef. Just about to fight a boss, I think. Masterworks all. You can't go wrong. Never forget, guys. Oops. Didn't want that. Okay. So I got pretty much full health. All my items are full. I have a big room here. I feel like it's going to be a boss fight. So I haven't really dodged in this game at all. Probably going to start doing that right about now. What's good, dude?
Once someone is lost, they can never come back.
Is that Oliver? I remember.
Cast aside your doubt.
Oh, she's my girl right there? Got a big camera. I know Alfred had a big camera.
Here we go.
What am I doing with that? I want this. I'm kind of low on blood stuff. Oh, I want to backstab this guy. I don't have that claw anymore. I seem to just replaced my claw with this other thing. Oh, hey there, big guy.
How about this?
Okay, I don't want that button. I see. Okay. Let him do his thing over there. I think I got low on health, though. I should heal him, huh? Here you go, big guy. Oof. I should have to stick with the wizard. That's how I'm playing. I'm pretty, very cowardly. Who, me be cowardly on the Vencabot stream? How often does that ever happen? In a Dark Souls game. Cut him up, dude, cut him up! Easy game. Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to Dark Souls, dude. Steve remembers. Steve and Dix remember.
She's alright.
Just being a fucking coward.
By the way, both of you.
All revenants must pay a levy. There are no exceptions.
A vestige. Best to stay away from those stones.
Why?
Anyone who touches them is defiled, transformed into the lost. Don't listen to their whispers.
Nah, dude, I can grab
them
special.
Someone has to be sacrificed. Without blood beads, we won't make it.
So we're about our protagonist here. We've been kind of getting hints that he's special in some way.
Down, let's get out of here.
He can do things other revenants can't do. He can restore missile that's dried up to make it bear blood beads again. Bet we can touch this thing and do something with it. The miasma that made this boss an enemy, exactly. There's like a fog in the air that makes us go lost faster. So we have to wear these mask things. Yeah, the blood beads, Rograve, they're fruit that grows in these trees. Basically, we're in a post-apocalypse where there's no humans left. We're all vampires. We're called revenants. And if we don't get these blood beads, we're going to go nuts. And so it's kind of like the only way to get blood these days for all these vampire guys. It grows on like blood trees, basically. But now those blood trees are all drying up. And for some reason, my protagonist can kind of restore them. So we haven't got that much story yet. We're just starting the game. But they're kind of implying he's like, you know, the savior or whatever. We have to go through and restore all the blood flowers so people can, you know, the blood plants, people can get these blood beads again. They haven't actually come out and said that yet, though. It's like a post-apocalypse rock, yeah, it's very wasteland-esque. Fair bit of the Dark Souls, one tutorial boss, huh? Maybe aesthetically, but he was much hella easy. There are some humans, but not very many, they said. Blood beads that grow on blood beads to stop vampires in post-apocalypse word from going crazy. I love this, huh? Grows on blood trees, yeah. Alright, well, can I talk to you?
I hear a voice.
Don't touch that thing.
I hear a voice.
I really want to touch this thing. I feel like I can, right? I probably can. Give me this treasure!
Wait, what are you...
Fuck!
Let go! It'll swallow you up!
No, it won't, dude. I'm the fucking protagonist.
It's all right. You can do it.
This is my waifu. I don't know who she is, but I have no memory. And she doesn't know me either. But she's very protective of me. I couldn't resist a treasure, guys. What did it give me?
What the hell?
This is the first time we're overtly seeing that my guy is some kind of special dude. They've been implying it that he can do stuff that other people can't do. They kind of been giving little hints, but now we know my guy's some kind of super revenant or something. I'm basically the Lorax. I speak for the Blood Trees. I'm the Blood Lorax. Okay, some kind of hallucination now, or some kind of memory or something.
Please, let us keep them just this once. We won't make it if you take them.
All revenants must pay a levy of blood bloods. There are no exceptions.
So maybe I'm inside of Oliver. I think that's the boss, Oliver. So Oliver was my first party member. And he got wounded and had to stay behind. And I think I had to fight him just now. But all these guys look the same to me. They're all a bunch of anime guys. So I think maybe I'm seeing his memories. The blood lords.
Mommy!
Someone has to be sacrificed. Without blood beads, we won't make it.
Yeah, this is kind of fun. This definitely beats Neo. Remember when Neo, you beat a boss in Neo? And you had to fucking hear the whole fucking backstory?
The few humans that remain are under Silva's control. Wandering revenants like us are forced to hunt for blood beads or face death. Even if some revenants must be sacrificed for our survival.
Okay, exposition. But kind of cool exposition.
I guess you reap what you sow, right? Well, that's all right. What's important is that at least one of us.
So that's where I left him. He got wounded when we were fighting. So he's on my party and he got wounded to stay behind. So I guess that's him talking to himself after I left. So I have like I used his like crystal, and now I can see his memories a little bit, I guess. So that's my waifu. That's me.
This is a memory echo. It's a place where lost recollections still wander.
Okay, well, that's what I need. I'm an amnesiac.
Come, let's move on. If you use that stone...
Well, that's not me. That's the other guy. See, I can't even tell the difference between me and the other guy.
The world outside this memory. This... Okay. Come.
Is this the past of one of the lost?
Oh, so I took him in with me. Okay. Kind of funny how glitchy that is. Like, for this big dramatic moment, they could have at least tested that and make sure it wouldn't look whack and walk up to the stairs. But whatever. I kind of like that, to be honest. Again, it's kind of a similar idea to, like, Neo, where you beat a boss and you have to hear the whole fucking backstory, but at least it wasn't literally just a fucking bunch of text on the screen.
Carved into that vestige by the one who left it behind.
I didn't expect that I'd get dragged into
it. Neither did I. That was kind of weird.
We both melted into you.
Damn, dude.
I can't believe this. A little bit whack, yeah. What a
huge
power.
Huge fucking anime titty. So distracting. That's why I didn't play a female character. That shit's just annoying.
Come with me. I know a spot where we can rest.
I love big boobies, but there's gotta be a limit.
I'm Louis. I'm researching blood beads.
Nice to meet you, Louis. You look just like me. Like, literally. I can't tell the difference between us.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, I guess my guy's got the dark things under his eyes. Alright, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't into it, guys. I'm kind of into it. I kind of want to see where this goes, story-wise. They got me. I kind of wish they added a slight effect when their masks are on. A slight effect? What do you mean? What kind of effect? Berserkers, I unlocked a new blood code. It's like a class. I got it from Oliver. So yeah, if I beat bosses, I get new classes. Features high strength and endurance. It's low ichor, that's my mana, like magic, stock, and can be also with heavy armor. That sounds like something I would want. Oh, a vocal effect. Yeah, that would be nice, Faust. That would be nice. I noticed, but you're right. That could make it a lot more immersive. Faust. You're a friend, dude.
Ugly.
Steve, Dix, all you guys. I care about this plot right now. I would have no reason to lie to you guys.
Showed up a short time after the queen was defeated. And when it did, it trapped everyone and everything inside, giving birth to the society of revenants ruled by
Silva.
Okay,
so Silva's the current guy who's in charge.
The Jail of the Mists. As time passed, that was the name people gave to the world inside.
Okay, so that's where we're at right now.
The creatures trapped inside the miasma wander in a never-ending cycle of death and rebirth, always searching for blood beads to sustain them.
But I can make those, dude. I've got the power.
Revenants need to have blood. Without it, they turn into those creatures we call the Lost.
Yeah, I know that already.
The revenants who captured you were desperately searching for blood, terrified of losing themselves. It's a common fate.
Yeah, so like I said,
days.
The game started with me getting kidnapped by a bunch of banditos and been forced into slavery.
The ripples are beginning to form. You cleared the miasma and revitalized the blood spring.
I did. It's a very anime choice.
Where did you learn to do
spelling
that?
Spelling jail is gaol. Didn't learn it, bro. I just do it. I have no memory, man. I'm not an anime protagonist.
You've forgotten? Anything you do remember?
No, not really. But this chick seems down with me, so that's cool.
Losing so much of your memory. I suppose it was the same for
her. Because you guys missed the first episode, neither me nor her have any memory, but she's very protective of me anyway.
Make yourself at home.
Okay. So this is like a hub, perhaps. Home base, it says. Well, it's gotta be the hub, then. Bloodborne does it, too, with a Hypogean Ghoul. Very anime. I can sit in my home base. That's pretty godly. Yeah. Feels good, man. How come everything in this universe is so big? Is that gonna be... Is that lore, you think? That's like my gold star. Is that lore? Like, all the fucking doors are gigantic. I assume it was just an oversight. This chair is gigantic. This says... I made my guy as small as I can make him. And look at him. I'm still, like, barely shorter than this guy. Because you are so small. But I'm not that small. Look how small. I'm not that small. Look, I'm not that small, dude. I tried to make him small, but I guess the smallest you can make him is not that small. Can I get some fucking booze? So there's my waifu.
It's warm here, isn't it?
I mean, if you say so. It's got a really chilly
Everyone
wind sound effect.
Everyone wants to know more about me. I don't know the answer to any of their questions.
I can't tell why they want to know more about me so much.
All I can remember is that my name is Io, and that my place is by your
side. So she has a name now.
My name... I have no idea what it means.
Well, neither do I.
I'm not sure. It was simply decided. One does what must be done.
I guess.
And for me, that is my mission.
It's a goddamn Rei Ayanami archetype, dude. Typical anime bimbo archetype. Isn't it weird how the little hand appears on the screen and the little cursor appears between the message boxes? It's really annoying. Hopefully they fix it on a patch eventually. It makes sense in Bloodborne because it's very Victorian era in design, yeah. She doesn't look very warm. She looks like she could use a sweater. Or a new dress, for that matter. Yeah, it's fucking annoying. I don't like her personality. I don't like him in Dark Souls either, in this game's defense. The whole Dark Souls waifus pissed me off. Because they're all like this.
I am not a very capable fighter.
They're all Rei Ayanami archetypes. We have no emotion of our own. We are just robots, kind of. Japanese robotic woman. We live only to serve. What is this? Enthralling magazine, huh? Alright, that's cool. Can I sit and read it? Looks comfy. Firekeeper. Man, fuck the Firekeeper. Wow. Let's just have this be the whole stream, guys. Look at this shit. Let's just pretend that we're all there and chilling. This shit looks godlike. This gold star was the best decision we ever made. Alright. Got a fucking piano? Oh my god. It's fucking Vampire Freaks fantasy, dude. look at that candy machine. Is there a candy machine? Can I use it? I can use the jukebox, but not the candy machine? Bruh, which is the first person view in this game. This one's literally a candy machine. But this is a candy machine right here. But this is apparently a candy machine. Look at this cool stuff on the wall. Like, honestly. This is a pretty cool place. Enough of that. No copyright strikes, please. Alright. A note's written on the edge of the map. Next objective, talk to Louis. They say his name is Louis, is that right? Louis, to gather more info. Exploration goal? None right now. Okay. That's cool. So we have a bunch of characters here. I guess they're all friends of Louis. Wow. Just wow.
You're an unfamiliar face. Has Louis stuck his head into another pot of trouble? Well, it's none of my business, really. Anyway, I'm Coco, a merchant by trade. Stop by if you need anything.
Nice to meet you, Coco. The Firekeeper is best girl. She's all right. She's not as annoying as other characters in the Souls franchise. Just appearance, huh? Nah, I don't really want to do that. Okay, candles and bathtub. Just bathtub out here in the middle of nowhere. I mean, I guess. It's post-apocalypse. Guess who fucking cares? I can go a lot of different ways here. So talk to Louis, right? So if I, as long as I don't do that, I can go wherever, probably. Go to Hot Spring? Oh, Lord have mercy, dude. Fucking anime games. Oh, we have bedrooms and shit that's godlike, though. That almost makes up for the Hot Spring. Lie down? Okay. What happens if I do that? Probably nothing, right? Ah, feels good, man. Feels good being an ideal anime protagonist. Oh my god. So slender, so androgynous. Getting all the hot 2D cuties. It's my archive, huh? Don't remember what that was. Okay. Can I use this bedroom too? Well, I can't. Okay, I'm about to say. So we have our own bedrooms. We have a cool place to hang out. We have like a bar and shit. This is definitely some sort of anime fantasy world. I don't mind it. At least it looks nice. That is old info. I wonder if the game's gonna look better than the intro area did. I was judgmental of the intro area's like style. I felt like it was very cheap. This area is godlike. It could just be a home base. It'd make the most godlike area in the game, right? Because you're gonna be here a lot. But there's a lot of little details going on here that were sort of lacking in that first map. If I had to guess, I would say that they're gonna be using a lot of reused tiles in very large areas to compensate for the game's relatively low budget compared to Dark Souls. But this area's got a lot of little fine detail. I wish the whole game was like this. Maybe it will be, for all I know. Can I climb this? No. This is literally like the basement. It's like we have all of our shit, I guess. There's even a kayak up there. That's godlike. Butt coffin for keeping all of my stuff. I got a lot of souls right now. I have a new class as well, so I can learn new abilities from a new class. And do that kind of thing. I kind of like big, dumb warrior classes. Especially the giant shield, even better. Do you have any new dialogue?
Sorry, but I'm in the middle of taking inventory. Try me again later if you still need something.
Okay. And she probably the same dialogue as well, right? Just probably that double question I can ask her.
It seems I can restore the blood code of a vestige's creator from elements left in the vestige.
Oh, so she's the one that does that.
If you find any vestiges, please let me know.
Okay, so in other words, I took Oliver's blood code and she made it into a class. Or his vestige, I guess. Any new dialogue?
It seems I can restore...
Okay, blah, 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 blah. That's Louis, so let's not talk to him. Who are you?
All revenants carry some secret with them.
Louis'
friend. Don't do anything funny. I'll be keeping an eye on you until this talk with Louis settles down.
right?
All revenants carry some secret with them. Don't do-
Okay. This is what, the shop?
Nice to meet you. If Lily brought you here, there must be some reason,
right?
The
cool sticker she has on the wall.
I'm Rin Murasame. I provide the back home support for all the explorers here.
Okay.
It's a pleasure.
So we're probably learn about this place eventually.
I have my own reasons for why I can't go into combat with you, but I'll provide your.
Most of the guy run this fucking shop. If
anyway,
I didn't run the fucking
relax
shop.
Relax and make yourself at home.
Okay, so how do I buy stuff? Can I do that right now or not?
I'll take care of all your weapon-related needs.
Vestiges are different from codes. Codes are classes. Vestiges are gifts. I think that vestige is that thing that he dropped, right? When I killed him, that crystal thing. That's literally what it is, right? And she can make classes out of those. Because she said before that I walked in the memory of the vestige. The gifts are like my spells and abilities, I know that. I think the vestige is literally that crystal thing. Look at this dude! Bunch of cool weapons and stuff. No stealing. Nice bike, dude. What's this item you have here? You have like a boombox. I'm not gonna play any more music.
There you are. The revenant that Louis sees so much potential in.
Davis, huh?
There you are. The revenant that Louis sees so much potential in.
Looking like the devil, dude.
I'm Davis. I go around for the provisional government as part of the investigation into the depths.
Oh, okay.
Just as a warning, try not to stir up any trouble.
So he's like a fucking cop.
If you do, I won't be able to do my job and, well, you get it, right?
Okay, that's kind of fun.
Just so there's no confusion, don't cause any trouble, okay? I need to be able to move freely, you see.
Nice fucking cape, dude.
Just so there's no confusion.
I wonder if all those quote-unquote veils... Apparently the veils with the armor you get. I noticed in the anime intro to the game that one of the main characters had this weird, like, spinal thing on his back. Just like that. I wonder if it's, like, canonically attached to the idea of these veils, these armors they wear. Or if it's just, like, this fashion at the time. I hear something. I hear treasure. I know treasure when I hear it. Oh, it's this thing. Rested a missile? Okay, well, I might as well. I can level up now. I can acquire and inherit gifts. Switch partners, that's cool. Presents. Tells presents. I haven't received any presents. Okay. Well, it's almost that time of year. Maybe I will at some point. Begin training. I don't think I want to do that. Maybe it means I can test my abilities and stuff there. But a badass fridge. Pool table? Okay. That's everything. I guess I should acquire the gifts for that new class that I got. For one thing. I have this. Berserker. From Oliver Collins. Okay. So this image is an image of Oliver, I see. I'm kind of curious what these images are supposed to be of. He's the guy that I got the caster from before I was, before I left my memory, and this guy as well. I got my ranger from him, I guess, and the fighter from him, I guess. This is my berserker. So I'm the only character that can change his blood code. We established that in the game's intro. That's one of my guy's weird powers. He's some kind of chosen one. He can change his blood code. I guess means change your class. All right, so what have I learned? I have learned from this class a blow of madness from the light side of the tree. Okay, it's active. Increase the power of your next attack. Okay, sounds useful. Dragon lunge. Dash forward and make a powerful overhead attack. An offensive skill performed with a two-handed sword or hammer. Balance up increases my balance. I think that means my poise from Dark Souls. Precision temporarily makes it easier to stagger enemies with your weapon. Okay, that's cool. Royal heart temporarily increases resistance to being staggered. Because it's not balanced then. That's where balance is. Increases balance. Is that what I use for my focus? There's a mechanic called focus I haven't figured out yet. Like, I guess when I take damage or dodge attacks, I can get focus. When focus maxes out, I get like a focus state where I get special kinds of powers. I have no clue. Iron will temporarily reduces damage taken by weaving a barrier into your blood. Oh, nice. This class is my class, dude. In my class. There were lines that I couldn't change. I'm gonna learn all these abilities, pick up them all, and try to master them so I can use them elsewhere. So it says inherit abilities. It means I can inherit this. If I can master it by using it for a while or wearing it while I fight enemies and get EXP, it'll eventually become mastered. At that point, I can use it on any class, not just this class. Kind of reminds me of Final Fantasy Tactics a little bit with the JP system. You learn skills from one class and take them to another class. I think I'm mashing too fast. Did I say something different that time? I don't have enough for this, but I have a bunch of these, you know, hard souls. They're called lost shards, I think. Not like we were there for it, huh? Thanks for explaining the features of the game you already just learned to the rest of us, huh? Like we were there for it. Some of you guys weren't, Dick. Some of you guys, I already explained it like twice in this stream, even. Some guys are just showing up. Oops, my mistake. So I'm re-explaining stuff, you know, three times in the same stream. Okay, so I got tons of exp. Exp. Let's acquire more stuff, huh? If they aren't here for the long haul, they don't deserve to know. Maybe you're right, Dix. I don't know. You could be right. Maybe the viewers are just scum. Okay. So I got a bunch of gifts now. I can level up probably at least once. Okay. Get more HP and stamina, that's about it. Lots of HP though. So I'm getting a lot of HP here. 898 to 925. So I'm getting, well, it's not fair. Let's unequip this boost I have for one thing. Can I unequip? Yeah, I just do like this. So I have how much health? Right now. I have 748 health. If I level up, I'm getting 775. So let's do some counting here, guys, together. If I can't count, that's 27, I think, right? 27 HP and 1 stamina. Oh, it saves my builds per class. Well, that's kind of good. That's a good thing. Okay. Okay, let's see. So I'm looking at 21 HP here, but that's just, all right, well, we have to do it like this, we have to change to it, we have to level up like this, right? That's 21. Okay. If I change back to a warrior though, I get 21 as well. So I guess I think that means that I'm good. Doesn't matter what class I am, huh? Thank you, Dix. I'm too dumb to figure that on my own. Hey, Vencabot, could you explain how gifts work, huh? The gifts. So you're trying to be a scumbag, dude. Trying to be a scumbag who wasn't here from the beginning. Rocket's here in spirit. That does definitely count, dude. Definitely counts. Okay, so... I'm gonna just take all this shit off. I don't like that. It makes sense that it's saving it. It's a good thing. But to me, it feels so... Can I change my... Is my gear per class as well? Probably not. I guess not, huh? But my abilities and shit are. So they're all cleaned off now. Let's... this one comes from stuff too. 775 is what it would have been as a warrior when you checked. Okay, thank you, Dix. I kind of thought that, but I had lost track. I'd already forgotten by that point. How come I can't use this anymore? Type of thraldom. Requires some amount of dex. So I have very low dex in this class. Can't unequip this though. Equip this on this? No, I can't. I can only equip one at a time. Alright, well. I guess I put my axe on. So what's up with this? This has more defense, the Hammer of Thraldom. By about 10%. That's cool. But much lower attack power. So in this game, your weapons are your shields. They have to kind of sacrifice attack for defense and vice versa, because if you're holding L1, he kind of blocks the shield, and does not absorb all damage. Damage gets through, depending on how much defense you have. Oh, Juggernaut Sledgehammer. That was from Oliver, I think, right? I know I got that. Yeah, used by Oliver. Okay, I see. So that's better across the board, but heavier. I have very high max weight now, though, for being a berserker. I need more of these veils. This is way better for my gifts, but it doesn't really matter that much. Okay. Sick. So, I can put on some of these passives now. I want to have a health boost. I want a stamina boost. They're just straight up. Very simple to understand. Weapon dream rating up, I guess. I don't totally understand what this means yet. It was explained to me last time that apparently I get Ichor back into my mana just for attacking. But I never noticed that before. I don't have to use my Red Claw. The Red Claw is a way to do it faster. Also, I seem to have lost my Red Claw. What happened to that? I have this weird tail thing now. Maybe only in boss fights? It seemed like it was slower, though. Not sure what balance is, but it increases it. So that seems good enough to me. I don't really care about my focus state. There. Those are all just straight up passives. Very simple, straightforward. Alright, so I have Blow of Madness. I'm going to put on all of my Berserker skills, basically, because they haven't been mastered yet. If I'm wearing them, they get XP, basically. I don't really care what they're on, either. I'm not going to use them, probably. They don't have the little star means are mastered. Little star in the upper right. Your drain attack is based on your veil thinly. Veil thingy. Okay, so basically my armor changes its animation, huh? So because I put on that new armor, I have a tail now. Thank you, Steve. Okay, so I have all the ones on right now that are not mastered. Nice. Nice. I don't care about anything else, to be honest. I could put on like that weird thing that powers me up, like it raises my attack power, but I just don't care. Maybe the fights get hard enough, I'll care. Okay, so now we're good to go. Feeling young and strong, let's go talk to Lewis. Did you rescue Egghead? Rescue Egghead? Egghead. Did you mean Oliver, who we left behind? Or do you mean, oh, you mean the girl, yeah, we rescued the girl, yeah. Welcome back, Dix. We beat the first boss, rescued the girl. Her name is Io, Dix, we learned that recently. But her boobies ain't quite as big as this girl's boobies, so I like her more now. For that reason exclusively. But I think the first boss, it was dumb. It was real dumb. It would've been more fun without a partner. My partner just killed him for me, basically. I just ran away and let him fight him. And he killed him. Okay. That's pretty rough, huh? Yeah, I mean, it was the first boss in the game. Also, you could argue, right? Here we go, Cool Hand. Maybe I'm only arguing because I like this game so far. And normally, you know, I'd be more critical. But let me just say that maybe they were successfully conveying a core theme of this game, that friendship is important and your homies are cool. It's good to have homies with you, right? Because, I mean, canonically, he's supposed to be a pretty buff guy, I guess. Now he's like, you know, an adventurer. I'm just some kind of scrub. Maybe it makes sense that the first boss I could just let him deal with, right? Maybe it means, you know, thematically, that I'm sort of reliant on this guy. Right? I don't know. But it was a pretty fucking easy boss. Like, seriously. I've always wondered if you could remedy allies by putting out a certain number of enemies that are meant to be killed by your partner, and after that, they get downed or something, huh? Or get tired or pinned down or whatever. I can also ditch the allies, because I think I can in this game, I think. Let's go find out. I can switch partners now. On this thing. At least unlock that ability, I think. Yeah, I don't know. I'm kind of iffy on the whole idea of partners in a game like this, Cool Hand, in general. I was talking about that earlier, about, you know, partners and how they make it more confusing than it needs to be, and otherwise you can just rely on them sometimes. But in this case, because you asked about the boss fight in particular, Cool Hand. Yeah, basically, the boss, I just kind of ran away and my guy handled him. I ran away and I shot little, I have little spells, so like, spell, and the boss would be like, right? And he'd be like, and he'd start coming toward me, and I would just do my dash attack away, and my little dash, my little iframe dodge. And then my partner would be like, hey, you come back here, and he'd be like, and eventually they'd fight for a while, and I just kind of pelt him. I basically didn't fight him at all. I healed my partner once, though. I did do that. That was cool. Switch partner. See, I can go none if I want to. Maybe I do want to go none. I'm going to keep Lewis on for now, though. Just to see how the mechanic shapes up. Because on our last stream, I said this, right? I really find that having partners in most genres of game is almost always more of a hassle than it's worth. And it usually detracts from the game design. Like, I feel like the game becomes looser because of that. This game so far has been no exception. So far, I feel like having a partner has been a distraction and something I can over-rely on. So I find that it's kind of, even when I do want to fight, it's like I really feel like it's harder for me to fight because I'm not sure what health or who the, like, it's a lot easier to play a game like this when I know how much health the enemy's going to have. I know who he's targeting. If I don't know who he's targeting, then it causes, you know, problems. So, but I played a game a few years ago called Guided Fate Paradox, which is a game that was a sequel to a single player, a one character game called Zetai Hero Project. It's a roguelike. And the sequel to Zetai Hero was Guided Fate, and it had this mechanic where you always had a partner. And I thought I would hate it, but they kind of put it in the game in a very, very clever way. Ended up actually improving the game in a big way. So this game has a whole partner mechanic. Let's just go with a partner, see how it goes for now. If I end up hating it for this next dungeon, I'll probably swap them out and have none.
The ability to draw strength from experiencing memories, and the power to revitalize blood springs, both unprecedented. Sorry, but could I get a sample of your blood? We might understand more if we analyzed it.
Sure.
It won't be much, just a small vial, so you won't need to worry about bloodthirst. It'll take a while to get the results. Take it easy in the room back there while you wait.
Okay, interesting. The fuck no, man, it's my blood, dude. He's gonna clone you, replace you with his you slave or some shit, huh? Maybe. It is anime. Doesn't this game have multiplayer? Get Steve to be your partner, huh? I'm not sure if it does. It has online mode. I'm not sure if you can actually play co-op. You probably can, you would think. That's one reason why I never really played co-op that much in Dark Souls, for the same reason, right? I feel like a game like this, when you have only one player on the field, it makes everything easier to manage. Having more than one, it sort of complicates things, I feel. Definitely gonna die after that event, huh? What's up, Louis?
I've done what I can to look into your talents, and I've confirmed something surprising.
What? What do you confirm, dude?
Revenants have blood types that differ from those of humans. These types greatly affect a revenant's abilities.
Yep.
However, your blood has no specific type.
Yeah, I know. I learned that in the tutorial.
More accurately, your type is broken.
You're on Xbox. I didn't even know you had an Xbox, dude.
And the fact that you have no specific type might be due to your being what we call a void type.
Mm-hmm.
You were able to gain another revenant's power through a vestige, right?
Wait, so I'm not the only guy that can do that?
Is unique to void
I thought
types.
I was the fucking chosen one, dude. There's
a
void
type.
Suppose
you are a void type. There's a test I'd like to perform. Don't worry, you'll get something out of it. I'm going to give you some of my blood.
Okay. Want to get your class?
If correct, it should act as a medium that will give my power to you.
Well, that's badass.
Well, here goes.
Give me your blood, dude. We're friends. You can give me some of your blood. Yeah, that was cheap. Prometheus. Well balanced for combat, but fragile. It gives bolster dodging and parrying. Huh? I forgot I had a parry. Got a new blood code. So what's cool about that is that, you know, the game is opening up. They give me two new classes at once. That's kind of fun. I bet they all got the HIV. They might.
Did you go visit Morisame and Coco? They should be ready to do business.
You don't have any dialogue about how I got your class?
Weapons and blood veils are vital parts of a revenant's kit when exploring. You should take another look at them. If you've got materials...
Oh, dude, trust me. We're taking plenty of looks at them.
Once you've got that settled, talk to me again, and we'll continue where we left off.
Okay. Coco, Louis, I should look at you. Do I have permission?
I've got just about anything you could want.
Let's see here.
Even the lost are valuable customers if they bring the right coin. Let me know if you need anything. Even the lost are...
Okay. Exchange what for what? Give valuables, receive items. I have these valuables that I've been finding. I'm not sure what they're for. They all say this item's value varies wildly depending on who holds it. I'm not sure what that means. They all say that, though. But only this one has a comma. Look at it. The yellow book says, this item's value varies wildly, comma, depending on who holds it. The other ones don't. Interesting. Is that a hint? Or is it just a typo? Some may be overwhelmed by the amount of words inside, but the clever turns of phrase and the rhythm of the language used to draw readers into a new world. So I guess, the clever turns of phrase and the rhythm of the language used to draw readers into a new world. Actually, I used to. Local pennant, huh? A small flag often seen at souvenir shops. It's unique design, so I guess you have to know the character's personality, know who to give them to, perhaps? Antique coin. This coin has gained value as a historic piece of art. The design tells the circumstances of the time it was minted. A well-worn tool is for her. Right, she's working on this car or some shit. The passage of time has given this tool a dignified patina. What the hell is a patina? It's still as functional as ever and would be prized by someone who does delicate work. Geisha noodles. High-quality instant noodles served at expensive restaurants in the Far East before the Great Collapse. A single bite is said to open your eyes to a new world of taste. Okay, that's kind of fun. So you have to kind of increase their you know, you have to give them gifts and increase their, whatever, their affection. You have to know what they want. That's kind of fun. In a fucking anime kind of way. Alright. Receive items. Trading points needed. So wait, I give them stuff and they get trading points. Oh my god, so mercenary, dude. Fuck your affection meter. Oh, it's just oxidation, literally, huh? Patina. It's like a coating that makes something look antique, I think. Kind of like oxidation. Okay, patina means oxidation. So if I give her enough stuff, I can get some cool items. Okay. It's kind of like a bartering system. It doesn't give you any hint, though, about how much you're going to get. I don't think. You have to just know. That's fun. Could be worse. Stamp. Praise 2. An item that grants use of the Praise 2 stamp. That's what a stamp is. Mercury chrome, a highly valuable mineral made from special ore mixed with blood. Ask more Sami to use this to transform a weapon or a blood veil and imbue it with obstructive properties, creating an equipment specialized in slowing enemies at the cost of decreased attack and gift properties. All right. That's fun.
If you want it, I got it.
You want it, I got it. Ichor concentrate, so it's kind of like, oh, I see, it's like a little mana restoring thing. Anti-venoms, anti-stuns, okay. Coagulants. Daggers. Blood markers. Grows dimly when the solution is mixed with Revenant's blood. Due to the bound in blood, it can always show its position to its owner from afar. Like a waypoint. Okay, that's cool. That's really cool.
Come again soon.
Biney! Any new dialogue for me?
All Revenants carry some secret with don't do...
But you have new stuff for me.
Oh, good timing. I've got everything set up now. What do you need?
She sounds very familiar. Talk.
I know it's a bother, but I'll need you to bring the necessary materials if you want to upgrade a weapon. There's a shortage of pretty much everything these days. Still, we're better off than most people.
Okay.
I know it's a bother.
So I can do the same thing with her. What do you have to receive? Different stuff. Praise gesture. You don't have to stamp praise. Hephaestus crumb, so it's a different kind of mineral to make stuff with. Okay, she has two of those. Upgrade equipment and transform equipment. So I can upgrade or transform it? That's cool. I can buy stuff.
Thanks
Ooh,
to everyone's hard
fun.
Work, I can offer new weapons. Take a look if you'd like. Buying something?
Okay. So these are all the weapons, I guess, right here. So she doesn't really have a whole lot. I already have all this stuff. Is that their way of telling me that I only buy stuff that I already have? I think it's literally all the weapons I have, right? Like, they're all the ones I already have. But, yeah, there's the pipe. So I guess once I find a weapon, I can just buy it, but I already have one. I have storage. Don't understand. Oh, but I can transform mine. Right, okay. So I transform mine, then I have to rebuy it to get it back. Right? If I'm not mistaken, those are literally the ones that I have, like all of them. Well, no, I'm just still missing some. The lost broadsword is not there. The lost bayonet is not there. The juggernaut's not there. So it's not all my stuff yet.
Hi. Did you need... buying something?
Yes. I just clicked to buy something. Yeah, so it doesn't have all my stuff. It doesn't have the lost bayonet, or the lost greatsword, or the giant hammer. Maybe there's some that are one of a kind, huh? Perhaps. Or I guess I'll unlock it later. Buy a blood veil. Now, this is what I want, because I don't have any good blood veils. I only got three of these. They're organized by type. Oh, this is based on the type of... this is what Steve was saying, right? Some are claws, some are tails. This changes my kind of drain that I have. Okay, that's cool. I don't really care, though. I'm really more concerned with the stats, but maybe I should care. It seems like that tail thing was slower. It changed my attack in general. Can I train over here? Is that what the training is for? Can I, like, test my stuff? That's what it's for over here. Oh, how about that? So here's my giant hammer majig. Okay. I think it's not quite as strong as this, though. Or is it stronger? They seem to be the same. They're the same type of thing. Same animation. Okay, so literally the same exact thing? Oh, no, it's not. Oh, I'm tripping. Oh, I see. Okay, so yeah, it's not the same at all. Alright, so if I hold X, do I have this tail thing comes out? I do have a tail thing comes out. And it does appear different. So my claw used to have like a dash attack. This thing stays in place. And it goes pretty far forward. Maybe even as far as my dash used to go. This is better for mages, I don't want to get up close. Yes, that goes really far. About as far as my dash used to go. It's a little bit different. It seems a little bit slower. If I were to, let's say, do this and then this, that does seem slower. Okay. So there probably are pros and cons using different kinds of blood veils. Okay, that's fun. But it looks cooler. What looks cool? Do you think the tail looks cooler?
Hi. Did you need something?
Okay, so let's buy blood veil.
Something?
So it costs souls, probably, right? So I probably don't have a whole lot. I've been spending it on level ups. Queen Slayer Claw. Claw 2. What? It's just a better version, perhaps? What's the difference? Rebel Claw? They look different, I guess, or something. Okay. A blood veil used by forces in Operation Queenslayer. A modified Queenslayer claw. A specially dyed Queenslayer claw. They're all the same price. They have the same exact stats. I guess they must just look different, huh? Okay, so here we go. This one's different, actually. A Venus Claw, an ogre-type blood veil, used by the Lost. Low durability, but extremely lightweight. Okay. So not all of these have spin-offs. Festive Spear. A stinger-type blood veil with a festive coloring through at the end of the year. All right. Queenslayer Thorns, what I have on right now. Thorn 2. It's very expensive. I can get different colors of it. Okay, Festive Fang. This one is better for my heavy build. It has lower magic defense, like element defense, but higher physical defense. You guys know me. Love that physical defense. Also makes my drain better by quite a lot. Hmm. Says buy it. I think I'm too broke to buy it. Oh, I'm not. It's actually pretty cheap. We don't know what the fang looks like yet, huh? You're right. So what is this? These are the claws. These are the, what do they call these? Stingers, okay. And these are a hound type. Okay, a little hound image there. This is a thorn type. Okay. So these both boost my stats. At least for this set. Again, different classes of different different sets. They're cheap because it's a shitty Christmas gear. Huh? Oh, is it really? That makes sense. Is it busted as fuck too? Cause probably not. I mean, I'll probably get better stuff later on. I mean, it gives my adrenaline a huge boost. I am losing gift stuff though. Also, it weighs a lot. This one's reducing my resistances a lot. Hopefully, it's not too busted. I hate DLC stuff that comes out so busted, huh? Tick's trying to get me to buy some shitty Christmas stuff. I might anyway. It's got higher stats. This is the one that I want. The Festive Fang. Gives me more defense. Buy it, it looks like.
Okay. Take care then.
Bye, me. What do the other ones cost? They cost in the thousands. This one right here that I'm wearing right now costs 9,000. I just found it. This one actually costs 9,000 to buy. I don't even never had that much before. Okay. So this is gonna give me shittier strength scaling, okay. Better mobility. So wait, so even though I'm below my weight requirement, my weight limit, but different veils still change my mobility. So mobility is not based exclusively on your weight. Right, I'm slow with this, even though I'm still well within my weight limit. Okay, interesting. So just by wearing this, I'm slow. Let's see what it looks like. Okay, oh wow, that's really fucking festive. That's so festive. So I have a hound type drain now. Oh, cool. Oh, it's twice. I'm hoping for green, huh? If you tell me it was green, I'd believe you, Dix. I don't fucking know. So that did 898 on the second hit. If I charge it even more, do I get more damage? No. So once it flashes, I can let it rip. If I let it go too early, it aborts. But if I hold it to the flash, there. Now I can use it. I can hold it indefinitely. I can charge it and wait for them to come as well. Those that are coming toward me, I can charge it. I can wait forever. But it doesn't charge any more beyond that. That's pretty fucking cool. Before I do the combo version of it. Okay. Pretty fast. I like that. Okay, but yeah, it is extremely festive. But I'm not totally sure that I care. So I'm probably still gonna wear it. Kill the dummy, huh? Kill the dummy, kill. Oh, actually, that's health. I think it's restoring between hits, though, right? No? Oh, it does. Okay, we have to get like a really long combo. Probably could destroy it. We're getting there. If I keep hitting it, it won't restore. God damn it, Dix. Why are you so full of bad ideas that I love? We're getting there, boys. I play Dark Souls games for cool, man. I have stamina. See my little stamina bar? I can't go beyond that. I'm trying to let it restore a little bit between everybody. There's up, Deadlock! Anime Souls. Who plays with Souls? Who shows up? OTF Deadlock. We just talked about the old Dark Souls 3 Fight Club days, dude. The good old days. Oh, I killed it and got all the health back. That's boring. Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, it's behind my head, right? I apologize about that. Alright, so I guess the jack's good enough for now. Let's take a look at what it means to transform or upgrade a weapon.
Hi.
And or
did you
veil.
Need something?
Upgrade equipment, I guess. Upgrade weapon.
What do you want to upgrade?
Well, I like my big giant Queenslayer thing. What does it need? It needs haze and it needs Queen's Iron. I have three of those. I can give it quite a lot more attack power. More than 10% boost. Or I guess pretty much exactly 10% boost. I miss those days of blood and honor. The good old days, the good old days. Dark Souls fuck up Doostra. Talk to Yakumo. Who the fuck is Yakumo, Steve? Okay. That's what it means to upgrade. How about upgrade my blood veil?
Which blood veil do you want to upgrade?
Because I spent all my stuff on buying new abilities, Cool Hand. And level ups. I'm mad broke. So this is what I'm wearing. It costs Queen's Iron to upgrade this. And again, it goes up by pretty much 10%. Okay. Pretty cool. Stop being poor, huh? Maybe I will, Cool Hand. Maybe I will. I'm going to get a job. Only the best boy, Yakumo. Okay, so can I transform stuff? Transform
weapon. Which weapon do you want to transform?
What does that mean? An in-game Patreon? That'd be so sick, Dix. In-game Patreon. Okay, what if I want to transform this? Okay, that was in Dark Souls 2, wasn't it? I forgot about that. Right? I can upgrade it linearly, or I can imbue it with all kinds of other crazy properties. Okay, that's fun. I need this chrome stuff. So chrome is for transforming, and iron is for upgrading. Okay, cool. I will, Cool Hand. I have that much money, dude. Don't count me out yet. I'll come back. I was always coming back.
Which blood veil do you want to transform?
The one I'm wearing. The shiny one that says Christmas on the back. Okay, I see. All right, cool. It's fun. Cool Hand. I'm never going to clap back at society if you can't give me some space, dude. You can't keep trying to pin me down because I'm underclass. Alright. Good enough for me.
Okay.
Are you Yakumo?
All revenants carry some secret.
He has no name. There is no Yakumo, Steve. Yakumo doesn't exist. Who's up, Duckface? Anka Nama. Hey, what's up, Decoy? Yo, everybody's turning out, dude. Everybody's turning out. We got Deadlock, we got Duckface, we got Decoy Mantis. Yeah, I think that's probably Yakumo, and I don't think there's anybody else here, to my knowledge. There's a couple of booby ladies, and there's a couple of, super suave guys. Yakumo, are you around here, dude? Is there a guy named Yakumo here? Yakumo, are you down here? I don't think so. Probably that guy that won't tell me his name. I've got my eye on you. You fucking weirdo. How's the holidays been going, Venka? You know me, dude. You know me. Not especially well off financially. Lots of gifts to buy. Groceries to buy. Things to buy. That's true of a lot of people, though. I finally got back to my Twitch old account. I did have to give credit card numbers, etc. Really, Duckface? Look at my fucking choker, dude! Oh, man! Oh, my God! My monocle, bro? Were the monocle to the hot spring? Look at my flip-flops, son! Those are not sandals. They might technically be sandals, but those are flip-flops. You can hear them flipping and flopping. You're gonna hear the flip-flops flipping and flopping. Somebody actually programmed that sound into the game. Decoy, mostly yes, mostly. Very painful, but yes. Wow. This place is amazing. What a fucking fantasy this place is. Oh, hi. There are ladies in there. This fucking co-ed. Thank you for the $35, Coolahan. This reminds me. No, thank you, Coolahan. Merry Christmas, man. That's gonna make my holiday expenditures a little bit easier. I want to see what I bought for my friends and family for Christmas. You can't tell them what it is, though. If you guys are watching right now, anybody that's in my, you know, my family, then stop watching right now. I think I have it right here, actually. I bought my friend Ayn a couple of Switch games, Civilization, and a game that I got from Europe called Unravel 2 for him and his girlfriend to play. Got my brother a SSD for his computer. You guys are into music production, might know one of these. This is a pocket operator from my friend who's like a computer nerd. And he's into music. This is a little calculator, basically, that's actually a groove box, so you can make chip tunes on it. That's pretty neat. Speaking of music, I got my brother's wife this Korg Monitron Delay. If you guys are into synths, you already know about the Monitron Delay. It's like a little toy synth size device. It's not toy synth price. It's very cool, though. It's kind of like makes spacey sounds. For my mom, I bought this Sprocket, HP Sprocket. It's a little mini printer for printing off photos from your phone, basically. And she's big into taking photos. You might enjoy that. Decor looks Unravel as well. So you guys know Unravel. I guess the sequel only came out in Europe, from what I understand. Maybe only physically in Europe. I'm doing my best, Cool Hand, but it's not cheap, though. And back when I was working full-time, I really took a lot of pride in the gifts that I chose for people. And oftentimes they were, you know, a little bit high-end. And I find that now that I'm not making that same income, it's pretty rough. It sucks. You guys know. Some of you guys that are watching know the struggle. It sucks when you're not really that well off financially. You have to pick and choose, like, who gets gifts this year. Like, that's really, really rough. It sucks when you're like, well, that person, you know, I love that person, but they're, you know, they're extended family. Right? That really sucks. But, you know, again, I'm not the only guy going through that every season. I've been off using Twitch, like, almost 4 to 6 months, and 2 months ago I did get my car. Good stuff, dude. Wow, Duckface, got your license? Hopefully you're enjoying it. Be careful out there, of course, especially this time of year. There's lots of snow. Drive safe, but driving is so much fun, right? I love it. It's the friend guy. I don't know why he's being so dodgy. Yeah, that guy, the Yakumo. The holiday spoilers, hopefully nobody's watching those. Those are the gifts that I'm there for. I gotta find a gift yet still for my father and for my grandmother. It's gonna be pretty much all the, you know, the gifts I'm giving out this year. I didn't bother getting my license until I was like 19. They give him Cool Hand for $35. And that goes a really long way. I appreciate that. Okay. Wow. Well, I guess it is, you know, post-apocalypse. I'm always hang out in the hot spring together. Gotta keep the species alive, after all. Oh, I can see her up close now. She has her fucking eye makeup better than mine, dude. I'm so jealous. She has better eye makeup than me. Oh, hi. Hey, it's Louie. We all kind of come and hang out together. That's godlike. How much first person do I look at him? That's amazing. This is hilarious, dude. You don't want to, like, have a big hot tub orgy? We could do that. I'm down. Is that into it at all? Maybe a little bit? Maybe later? We gotta wait for Yakumo to show up, Steve. Maybe he won't be so uptight. We all get in the hot spring together. I could walk to school and work and save a shitload of money, but everyone thought I was a bum. Huh? Dude, it's good for exercise, too. I walked for years. I only got my driver's license when I was, like, 23 or something. So even later than you, Cool Hand. I used to love walking, taking the bus. That was great. I kind of miss it a little bit. Somebody just fart. You guys hear that? I heard a fart. All right. Oh, look back on past memories. Should have been looking, trying to look under his towel, huh? Can we watch the cutscenes again? I would never, ever do that. What's triangle do? What? Oh, this is the chapters. Okay, I have different cutscenes per chapter. Okay. Finish organizing my thoughts, huh? All right. Yeah, walking is great. Wait, why am I her? What? Am I you now? What? How did I become her? That's interesting. Can I still be here? That'd be sick. That was weird. Whatever. Right now, that's all about. Let's go on now, I guess, with the actual game. Anything new to say to me, girl? Yeah, I guess her name is Io.
It seems E-I-E-I-O. I can restore the blood code of a vestige's creator from elements left in the vestige.
Oh, okay.
If you find any...
Yeah. What's up, Brad? I'm all pimped out. Let's go kill some guys. Look at my amazing gold star.
Scene we witnessed at the vestige. That kind of stuff happens every day here. Silva has taken most of the humans who survived under his protection.
Okay.
So revenants are left to rely on blood beads alone to slake their unending thirst. But, well, nothing in this world lasts forever.
You saw me do it. I can fix these fucking things.
The springs started to dry up.
I can fix the springs.
So blood beads grew rarer and rarer.
Nice, Duckface. Can I drive somewhere with her?
By levying and distributing blood beads, won't last much longer either. The world needs more blood beads. Only then can we strive
my objective
for fairness.
We gotta find the springs and we gotta revive them. Let's go.
That's why we've been exploring the Jail of the Mists. We're doing research to learn all we can about blood beads.
Got it.
But the miasma has been a real problem. It makes our thirst even worse, so our progress is
stalled. Why do I care right now about this plot?
Now, though,
it's surprisingly coherent.
Your power can clear the miasma. If you could
I can restore fucking springs, dude. Let's do it. Let's save the world.
You'd be drawn into a bitter conflict.
How so? With what?
Still, the truth is, we don't have a lot
Who's
of hope
conflicted?
Without you.
Does this benefit everybody?
Will you join us?
Yeah, I mean, I'm down, dude. Can cure my asthma. I wish, dude.
So, it's a done deal?
Dramatic apple.
Well then, from now on, you're one of us.
Yeah, I guess, dude. Who are you, Axel? Better have it memorized. Like, give me my apple back, dude. He just threw it to me, man.
Shinanome. I'll be looking forward to seeing you in action.
Shake on it, bruh.
Let's get right into it. Here's what's going on.
Okay. What are we doing? Like, seriously,
We're studying blood beads and their springs. We want to know how and when blood springs appear, their cycles for producing beads, and the composition of the beads themselves.
Alright, makes sense to me. No one already knew this shit?
We've made a few discoveries. First of all, we found that there are tubes like capillaries running through the earth. We call them blood veins. And so far as we can determine, every single blood spring is located on top of one of these blood veins.
Makes sense. So are you drinking the life spring?
Also, after comparing blood beads and blood veins, we now know that they are mostly comprised of the same substances.
In other words, we can safely assume that blood springs always form along blood veins.
If you say so, bro. Sounds all pretty hackneyed to me.
That means there must be a source somewhere. A kind of headwaters for the blood beads.
I guess.
Now that we have you around to clear the miasma, we can investigate the springs and follow the blood veins.
Alright, makes sense to me.
And hopefully, find the source.
So it says that Gaol and Gaol are pronounced the same. Okay.
We want to check out the old city ruins first. Sorry for the rush, but we should head out as soon as
Let's do it, bro. I want to kill some guys, man. I've been sitting here forever, it feels like. Let's go fight some guys. Alright, you can move from one missile to another one as long as they're activated, huh? Note that it's not enough to have visited an area. You must activate the missile I got so I can teleport, yeah, kind of like in, you know, Dark Souls. Alright. Hey, you might not be mean to me anymore.
Hey, what's up?
Let's talk.
The lost are what's left of revenants who've succumbed to their thirst. Their boar parasites take over.
Tell the boar parasite.
Turning them into unkillable monsters. Turn them to ash and they'll just keep popping back up. Mindlessly hunting blood. Nothing human is left.
Got it.
If you're fighting them, show no mercy. Keep at them no matter how many times it takes. If you don't, you'll find yourself.
This man's shirt is so tight you can see his belly button. The shirt is going inside the belly button. That's pretty tight.
We're headed for a nasty place where the miasma never goes away.
Yeah, close to your belly buttons here.
The miasma accelerates the thirst for blood. Wearing a mask helps, but even that has its limits. With your ability to disperse the miasma, though, we might be in the clear. Here's hoping.
Why not fucking look at me when I talk to you, motherfucker?
The lost are what's left of revenants who've succumbed to their thirst.
Okay.
Their boar parasites take over, turning them into unkillable monsters. Turn them to ash and they'll just...
Okay. So we can exchange stuff, switch partner here. Like I said, he becomes my partner, I guess?
Okay. I'm ready when you are.
Alright.
Hey. See you around.
Alright, it's weird. I could have done that at the missile, too.
It was easier to explore when we could use all the missile. The sacrifices of many provided paths into the depths.
Okay, I'm not gonna talk about how that works, but...
But now, even the staunchest explorers are swallowed up by the worsening environment or swarms of the lost. They must have left coordinates leading to the depths, but most of those were lost along with the
explorers. It's like your motorcycle dude kind of matches your color scheme.
If you find any maps of the depths out there, I'd appreciate it if you showed them to me.
Okay.
We'll take care of the rest. Once we've read the data, the one who discovered it gets priority for journeys there.
So you're going to take my hard work, I guess?
There are rumors around of a revenant attacking other revenants. Foolish to turn on your kind like that. The government is considering taking action.
Oh, the hunter. We learned about him before.
So-called hunter. Don't do anything senseless.
It's not me, dude. Maybe it was me. I don't know. I don't have any memories.
The organization I belong to is part of the government. People tend to drop the...
So the government, is that Silva?
Gregorio Silva assembled it around the military to help manage the turmoil after the war against the Queen.
Okay, we heard about that a little bit, about this whole Queen character.
The lost born in the war still roam unchecked.
Probably going to learn more as the story goes on. Pretty fun, actually. Could be worse.
And we can do little but survive. The fighting continues, and so the provisional body, too, continues. An unchanging fact of life.
Got it, bruh.
My one wish is that we can take our world back and restore peace. There are rumors around.
All right.
The organization I belong to.
Shut up. Have a good day, sir. All right, Steve. Here to talk to you again, Yakumo.
Hey,
what's up, dude?
What's up?
What?
The lost are what's left of revenants. Who've turned them.
Nothing, Steve. What do you want?
See you around.
See you around, bruh. I'm gonna go for a short break here, guys. I'm gonna go for like a 5-minute break. Come back and go to this new dungeon. I will see you guys very shortly with that. I just feel like I need to get up and use the bathroom and stuff. 1 second, guys. I'll be right back. Before I go, though, let me give a special thank you to guys to help out financially speaking. Leo getting a cool hand for helping out with that nice, juicy donation. Thank you to our patrons as well. That's at patreon.com/Vencabot, like the Black Knights, John Hernandez, Your Salty Face, and Zanzu. Thank you to the Fearless Havels, Audrey Apples, Crime Alley, Dick Zucker, Good Vibe City, Max and Mutant XP, and the Shady Winners, that's $3 a month. Foul Mill, GK Lai, Juna Anon, Kyle Glass, Leon Madison, Rebecca Jeter, Rufio Jones, Super Chatsky, and Toxic Vamp. And thank you to the Young Guy, that's $1 a month, goes a very long way, guys. Benjamin J. Harkins, Brandon Williams, Dapper Dons, Edward Kenneth Perez, Herb Durkin, I'm Joy Cruz, Kaiju, Kenneth, and Rock Sepulveda. That sounds pretty gay. Nothing wrong with that. Thank you to our subs here on Twitch as well. It's not quite as cost-effective as Patreon is. Your dollar doesn't go quite as far on Twitch because Twitch takes half. But it is cool if you want the emojis and the the ad-free experience and stuff. Thank you to Zanzu and Cruz being a Black Knight and a Fearless Havel on Twitch, respectively. And the Shady Winners is Amazon Prime free sub tier. If you guys are Amazon Prime, you get a free sub every month. Don't forget that account. And the gift sub tier and the $5 sub tier. Thank you to Ash Lethal, Stuffy Muffin, Blue Abs, Bones Up, Bot, Vencabot, Caviez, Change Me WTF, Dapper Dons, Deadass, Matty B, Decoy Mantis, Dixicar, Eating Bitter, FPA Brian, Axe, FPA Eddie, Grime Yao, Herb Durkin, Infinoco, In Silo, J Bomb, 1901, Juna 2, Juan Zambo, Kaiju is Dead, Kyosuke, KG the Legend, Kanaki 666, Cool Hand, Locus 3S, Knightus Templar, Optimus Style, Overlord Steve, Real Yigen, Roadkill 3S, Rusted Gold, Solo, Snurterpurge, Synth X Player, Task Force Faust, Techplug, The Shen, 3 Vent, Trouble Deer 42, Vandal, 1113, Yoker Brain 3S, and Salty Face. And thank you to Club Studio for helping out behind the scenes on the stream, whether it be by co-hosting the show or helping out on YouTube or anything like that. Thank you to Danny Dante Gameplay, Dick Sucker, FPA Brian X, Good Vibe, K Reich Jr., Kyoto 3S Mutant Experience, Neon Riot, Knights Templar, Overlord Steve, Task Force Faust, and Zanzu. Get the derpy turtles. I am literally going to be right back. I'm going to use the bathroom and we'll play more of this game.